Yo, what's up, guys? So I'm doing something a little bit different here. Taking a little break from Xbox One and going to 360. I apologize. I'm picking this game up a little bit late in the first quarter. I actually wasn't planning on recording, but I just decided, what the hell, why not? Because I haven't done a 360 game in a long time, and I love the 360 gameplay. You guys have heard me say that before a million times. to me, it's a lot of fun. For all the quirky little glitches and stuff that there are, I still have fun playing it. And I'm so used to running this scheme that I run that I run the same exact game plan that I ran in 16. I'm sorry, 15. 16, excuse me. I'm going back 2 years now. I run the same exact scheme, offensively and defensively, that I ran in 16. And I'm so comfortable with it. And they did make some slight improvements in this game. So I have... Ooh, look at that swerve. Look at that stiff arm. Andrew Luck just teaching people some lesson. Plus, it's a little bit of a throwback, you know? I've just been having a lot of fun with it. Other than when I lag out of freaking games, that pisses me off. I'll get to my weekly picks in the second half probably. I'm not gonna spend too much time on it. He's lucky, man, because I thought I was gone there. Actually, no. I can start going through my picks now. There's a lot of divisional games this week, but I'll start with the Niners and the Bills. The Niners are 1-4. The Bills are 3-2. Surprisingly, 3-2 after a shaky start, and then they go into New England and shut them out, and they're on a roll right now. They're on a big time roll. So, the Niners, Kaepernick starting. I don't know what kind of... See, that's very calculated, the way the Niners did that. Kaepernick starting, but he's starting on the road. And I wonder if they did that because they're afraid of the kind of reception he would get at home, especially if he plays bad. Because let's face it, all this controversy that he's brought on himself with the national anthem and all that garbage... you know, he's done it to himself. I'm not going to get into all that nonsense about the flag and all that kind of stuff. I think it's wrong, but that's all I'm going to say on it. But I think the Bills are just on a roll right now. I think they're going to win. And they'll go to... hold on. That was a nice little play. So I think they're going to go to 4-2, and the Niners are going to drop to 1-5. Next game, you got the Redskins at the Eagles. Big divisional game for all teams involved in that division right now. The Giants, Eagles, Redskins, and Dallas. The Eagles are coming off their first loss. And Carson Wentz finally threw a pick. See, that's what I was trying to say about these rookie quarterbacks. They haven't really been tested yet. They haven't really had to drive their team down the field yet to win. And they finally had that happen to them, and the guy threw a pick. I'm not blaming him. Is he doing that? Oh, I thought he was going to... If he would have thrown that, I would have picked that off all day. The Redskins are down. Jordan Reed, he's not playing. And I think the Redskins are just kind of a squirrely team anyway. So it's in Philly. I think Philly is better, so I'm picking the Eagles to win. Throw it. Come on! I should have had that pick. It's in Philly. I think Philly's a better team, as much as I hate to say that. I think they will bounce back. I think Wentz will bounce back. I think the Eagles are going to win. I think the like I said, I think the Redskins are just too much of a squirrely team. Get him down. Here you go. So then, next game, you got the 0-5 Browns. They're just, they've been a mess for years, the Browns. They really have. They just, for whatever reason, they just can't find a quarterback. I don't know what it is. He loves that play. He loves running that play, even though it doesn't work. Let's see if he goes for it. Yeah, he's going to go for it. I would too, I guess. If I got scored on as easy as he did, I'd go for it too. The Browns are just a complete mess. The Titans are still building. They're not there yet, but they are definitely a better team. And until the Browns get their quarterback situation figured out, they're never going to go anywhere. So I'm picking the Titans. See, he wanted to throw it, but I had that covered nicely. Next game. This is a big game. You got the Panthers at the Saints. The Panthers are 1-4. The Saints are 1-3. But they are playing at home, and they're a different team at home. Cam Newton is back. If the Panthers are going to have any hope of doing anything this year, they've got to win this game. If they go 1-5, they're done. Their season's over. I do think that they're a better team than the Saints. I just think that they're a mess right now. They're in free fall. With that being said, I know the Saints play better at home, but I think the Saints are a better team. I'm picking the Panthers. On the road, Newton's back. He's got a lot of stuff to prove. Now, I've been saying this for years about running quarterbacks. All right, running quarterbacks don't win in the NFL. They just don't. And they run, they get hurt, and their careers don't last as long as they should because of the way they play. Cam Newton is a perfect example of that. This year, he's taken a beating this year. I mean, an absolute beating. Oh, come on. He's taking an absolute beating this year. So, he already missed a game now with a concussion. It's just one of those things. These guys got to learn how to play better from the pocket. Otherwise, they're just not going to go anywhere. Simple as that. There's just no way around it. So, with all that being said, and the Saints being better at home and all that kind of thing, I do think the Panthers are a better team. I think the Panthers are going to bounce back, and I think they're going to win. What that means for their season, we don't know yet, but I think it's going to help them. I would have liked the score there. That would have been nice, but I'll take the score right up the middle. I don't care. Next game, you got the Jaguars, they're 1-3. You got the Bears, they're 1-4. The Bears are another one of those teams that's just a mess. You can make the argument that Jay Cutler is basically done in Chicago. I don't think you'll see him play again for them unless something drastic happens. So they're in a situation where they're rebuilding anyway. I mean, they lost a lot of guys, Forte and all those guys, but I just think that they're a mess. And the Jaguars, even though their record doesn't show it, they have played a lot better this year. And I just think internally the Bears, they're just a mess. Plain and simple, they're just a mess. So I'm picking the Jaguars. Next game you got the Rams. They're 3-2 quietly. They're 3-2 at the Lions, who are 2-3. And Matthew Stafford's having a great year. Even though they're 2-3, Stafford himself is having a great year. And they actually pulled out a nice win last week. If you saw it, Darius Slay played a great game. He forced a fumble in that game, and then he had a pick at the end to seal it. I'm kind of leaning towards the Lions a little bit, only because I think that they got a little bit of momentum going, especially after that win. Like I said, that was a big win. You heard it all. You heard it all season how they can't close out games, and they finally did. So maybe that turns the corner for them. Next game is a joke, an absolute joke. You got the Steelers at the Dolphins. Steelers are 4-1. The Dolphins are 1-4. Ryan Tannehill can't stay upright. His offensive line is terrible. He's just getting sacked all over the place. I mean, even if he's not getting sacked, he's getting hit. The Steelers, on the other hand, are on fire. Roethlisberger is leading the league in touchdowns right now. He's playing like the best quarterback in football. And the Steelers is rolling. I would be shocked if challenge what? I don't even know what I was challenging. I was actually audibling. Whatever. I'd be shocked, absolutely shocked, if the Dolphins won that game. See, look, this guy is gonna kind of fuck me up a little bit here. Because he makes it look like he's blitzing his safeties down. Which he is doing. So that's why I was trying to audible before. That's a touchdown. Guy can't make it. Guy can't make it that obvious that he's blitzing his safeties. If he does that, I'm going to pick him apart. I'm trying to run the ball here. Next game, this is an interesting game. Okay, you got the Bengals 2-3 at the Patriots 4-1. And Brady was back last week, but let's face it, he played the Browns. Okay, anybody plays the Browns, that's an automatic win. So this week, it's going to be a little different. This is the real test now to see if Brady's actually back. That was clipping. How they didn't call clipping on... I don't understand how they didn't call clipping on that. Wow. They didn't call clipping. Oh, whatever. Not going to complain about it. Oh, I should have had that block. So this is the true test for Brady and the Patriots and whether they're going to... whether Brady's back and is Brady or not. I mean, he destroyed the Browns. Oh, okay, so he gets a kick return where they don't call clipping, and now he gets an onside kick. Awesome. I'll get back to the picks in a second. I'll tell you what, man, sometimes it's better to be lucky than good, huh? I'm picking the Patriots to win, by the way. They're at home. Yes, the Bengals are much better than the Bears, but there's no way. Patriots at home. Brady's back. He's got a lot to prove. A lot of people are saying that the Patriots might go undefeated now that Brady's back. And that very well might happen. I mean, they're just damn good, the Patriots. They really are. I mean, they went 3-1 without Brady. The next game you got, the Chiefs, they're 2-2 at the Raiders. The Raiders are 4-1. How about that? The Raiders are they're 4-1. They're having a great year. Derek Carr is having a good year. Fuck! I let him go. I should not have let him go. See, what I'm trying to do is I don't want to get beat deep. Sometimes it's the shorter routes that are the ones that are most effective, right into the quarterback sideline. Getting set on first down. So he can, I'll give him all this underneath crap all he wants. I mean, he's got 9 completions for 98 yards. If I had 9 completions, I'd have 200 yards. He likes to play it safe and underneath, which is fine. It's smart, but it's not going to win you a lot of games. I can tell you that. Ah, fuck! I was right there too. I was right there. My fault. How is that not a block, man? I'm right there. Every fucking time I'm right there. Yeah, you're not getting 2 in a row, dude. You got lucky with your kick return. This guy, truthfully, right now, this guy shouldn't have any points. Well, actually, no, I take that back. I shouldn't say that. I should not say that. Because even though they didn't call the clipping, if they would have, he still would have the ball, so who knows what it would have done on that drive. But the game definitely got a little dodgy here. I'm not worried about it because the guy, I mean, he's not going to stop me. Todd Gurley just running over everybody. So back to the Chiefs and the Raiders. The Raiders are 4-1. I mean, how about that? They're finally good. Their defense isn't doing anything, but offensively they're staying alive, and that's what's winning them games right now. And you gotta, you know, if you're a Raiders fan, hopefully they figure their defense out. The Chiefs, we all know what the Chiefs can do because the Chiefs have done it before. They can go on these little runs where they can win 5, 6, 7, 8 games in a row. They've done it before. Last year, they won a tear without Jamal Charles. So they're definitely capable of putting, you know, stringing a bunch of wins together. Lucky I didn't fumble there. Now see, there you go. I'm 6 for 6 for 139 yards. He's got 9 completions for 100 yards. I don't know who to pick in this game, actually. That was a dot. That was a nasty, nasty dot. Now, I said before, sometimes it's better to be lucky than good. That was a case for me, too, right there. Because that probably should have been a pick. But what I did is when I threw it, I pushed it back the other way. I precisioned it backwards. That was definitely a dot. I'll tell you that. I don't know, man. I honestly don't know who to pick in this game. I know the Chiefs are a more desperate team, but they've been there before. Where if they lose this game, it's not the end of the world for them, because they can, like I said, they can go off and win 6, 7, 8 games in a row. They did it before. The Raiders, on the other hand, if they want to go anywhere, this is a game they got to win. It's a divisional game. You know, they're the ones, to me, the Chiefs are the one, the Raiders are the ones that have something to prove here, not the Chiefs. Come on. Wow. He's going to score on a bullshit fucking screen. And he's doing his little skip. He's getting his ass kicked, by the way, and he's doing his little skip into the end zone. That should have been a block, too. I don't understand why I'm not getting these blocks. I should have 3 of them now. 3 blocks I should have. Jesus. See, I could be a dickhead, too. I don't like that shit. You're going to do your little fucking skip into the end zone on a lucky-ass play. Now, his passing yards are going to look a lot better now because of that one play. That kind of annoys me a little bit, to be honest with you. I'm going to pick the Raiders. I just think that they have a little more to prove right now. And the Chiefs have been in this situation before where it doesn't really affect them. Look at Gurley just knocking people around. I love that play. When it works, man, it's just so good. It's just deadly. The next game, you got the Falcons at the Seahawks. The Falcons are 4-1. The Seahawks are 3-1. The Falcons are on fire. They really are. I mean, you look what the Falcons are doing. You look what the Falcons are doing this year, and they're definitely on a roll. With that being said, though, we've seen them do this before. I said it last week. They started the season 5-0, and they wound up finishing 8-8. So look at that little swerve. And the Seahawks are in a little bit of a desperation mode right now. I don't know what the fuck just happened. I didn't call a timeout. Dot. Oh man, what a dot. Oh, he's taking his timeouts. I don't know why. Game's over. He's just wasting his timeouts. I think the Seahawks are a more desperate team. And I don't trust the Falcons because I've seen them do this before. So I'm picking the Seahawks. In Seattle, Seahawks got a... Look at that swerve, man. This is a beautiful swerve. So I'm picking the Seahawks. Next game, this is a really interesting game. You have the Cowboys at the Packers. You got the Cowboys offensive line against the Packers defensive line. Okay, you saw what they did to the Giants last week. Giants couldn't run the ball to save their lives. There, let me do my little skip into the end zone. The Cowboys' strength, obviously, is their offensive line. The Packers' defensive line is real. So it's going to be a really interesting game. It's in Green Bay. It's Aaron Rodgers. It's the Packers' defense. A rookie quarterback. He hasn't made any mistakes yet. I'm going to say it every week until it happens. Maybe this is the week he makes his mistake and costs him the game. I'm picking the Packers. That's gonna be a really interesting game to watch, though, because, like I said, strength against strength, as far as the lines go. Shit! He just caught me butt naked right there. You ran. Why would you run the ball? You go hurry up to run the ball. I mean, that's just stupid. He wasn't expecting that. I changed my defense. He just switched his play. I wasn't ready for that. And I got stuck on a lineman, which I hate. And that's why I hate it, because I couldn't adjust. See, now his passing yards look amazing. Where's my fucking defense to cover that? I had two guys on blues right there. Wow, did I fucking shit the bed on that drive. Last two games. You got the Colts at the Texans. The Texans are kind of like in the same boat as the Browns and the Bears, where they just don't have a quarterback, and now the Texans don't have J.J. Watt. Andrew Luck has been getting beat up a lot this year too, but he's Andrew Luck. I'm picking the Colts. And then the last game, you got the Jets at the Cardinals. Cardinals are 2-3. Jets are 1-4. The Jets season's over. No more Eric Decker. Ryan Fitzpatrick's playing awful. Okay, so, Eric, like I said, Eric Decker's out for the year. Brandon Marshall is their number one receiver, and as good as he is, this guy, he drops a lot of passes, man, and he drops key passes. Well, that sucked. I didn't get a chance to fucking, I gotta disconnect my goddamn... I gotta disconnect my connect, because that just fucking screwed me all up here. I should have blown this guy out. He's going back to the screen. You ain't gonna hit me with that bullshit twice, dude. You got lucky with it once. Ain't gonna happen again. I'm so pissed off I gave that play up. Oh, get at it! I was gonna say! If he didn't juke like that, he would have fucking scored just now. Wow. I played like shit in the end of that game. I mean, a win's a win, but holy God. So, let me finish my pick real quick. Jets, Cardinals. The Jets are a mess, plain and simple. They got quarterback problems. They got wide receiver problems. Their defense is terrible. It's in Arizona. Cardinals are winning that game. And it's one of those things, you know, I say this every week about certain teams. I'll be shocked if this, I'll be shocked if that. But that's another one of those examples. I'll be shocked if the Jets beat the Cardinals. In Arizona, I'll be shocked. So, there's my picks. I hope you guys like the gameplay. Like I said, it's a little different. It's not Xbox One, I understand that, but I like the 360 gameplay better. And that actually wound up being a really close, dodgy game. Partially my fault, partially the game, partially the guy. So, it was definitely dodgy. But you guys know the deal. Like, comment, subscribe. I'll see you next time. Later.